Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today we are going to talk about Meilisearch. Or Meilisearch, and it's kind of search that is using AI, they say, to have a really quick way of finding information in documents. And LibreChat is using it to find your conversations and figure out which conversation you should use if you are searching for your data later on. So it's used by LibreChat in a very small way, but it's still an integral part. So we're going to install it today and look at how to set it up and how it actually works. So let's start up by installing some dependencies here. So we switch over to my screen and we will install Git and curl, because we're gonna compile a Git repository and curl is used everywhere to download things. So let's just install those two small dependencies. Should go pretty fast. They're using some other components, but should be fairly quick. After that, we need to install Rust, because Rust is one of the things that we're gonna use to build this Meili application. It's a Rust application and it's pretty quick. Let's see, operation was interrupted before it could finish. Yeah, so now it's finished. So we're gonna run curl with the proto. Let's see, we can do like that. Of HTTPS, and we're gonna do TLS version 1.2 and then Rust up RS, and with SH we're gonna run that. Of course you can download this script and look at it before you actually run it. I know that it's pretty safe, so I'm gonna run it here, and it's also a test environment. I'm gonna proceed with a standard installation, and it's just installing the Rust binaries. So cargo is the way of packaging things and building things on a server, and then you have a Rust compiler and so on. So a couple of tools that you need in order to compile Rust programs. And after that, in your profile, on your in your home directory, you will have this command here, at least if you're running a Debian install. So this Debian I have here is a standard Debian that has no extra packages, just pure Debian. So you should be able to follow along in this guide here. And of course, everything I'm using here is going to be in a write-up later, so you don't need to copy-paste or write a bunch of stuff. So next up, after we have gone into a Rust environment, so we have everything available, we're going to clone down this Git repository and enter that directory. It's not a huge Git repository, but it will use a lot of dependencies. We will see that later. So the binary that we're gonna build now is 128 megabytes in size. So it's quite a large binary, but it makes the application quite snappy. And currently I'm running this on a machine with 8 cores. And let's look here. Did I not update it to have more cores? Nope, it's just one single core and 2 gigabytes of memory. So this compile will take at least a half an hour to complete. If you change it up to have 8 cores and or 4 cores and 8 gigabytes of memory, it will take about 10 minutes to build. So it's quite a large application, and I will get back to you when it actually has compiled. And we are back, and as you see, I restarted the machine, added 4 cores to it and 8 gigabytes of memory. For some kind of hypothetical, you can run this on a Raspberry Pi with only 1 CPU and 2 gigabytes of memory. I have built it, it takes a long time, and you have run it and you don't really see that much of a difference in finding things if your data set isn't huge. So let's continue here, and I will copy the built binary. So the built binary is in target release Meilisearch, and we'll copy that to USR local bin. And we need to apply the password again, because it took a while. And then we're gonna create a user here. So user add the shell of bin bash, system user, home dir, var, share, Meilisearch, and then a lightning fast AI search engine in this Meilisearch. So that's our comment. And then we're gonna create a bunch of directories here. So we're gonna create a dumps directory and one snapshots directory. And then we're gonna set the user of Meilisearch on this var share Meilisearch. So now we have a couple of directories and so on. So now we're gonna configure Meilisearch. I will put that configuration file in etc Meilisearch, and it's a TOML file. And then we put a couple of rows of configuration in here. First off, we need a path for the database. So I will just put that in data MS in our user directory. The environment in this case is going to be a production environment. You can take a development environment and it will be very verbose in what it types out. And then you need an HTTP address. You need a master key, so not everyone can query this database. This could be pretty much anything, as I just put in some random data there. No analytics, so it will not send back any information to their services. You can, of course, do that if you want. The highest payload here, so no of the documents should be more than 100 megabytes. I think that is fine. Log level info, so we don't get a lot of logs. So dump dir, if it needs to dump any information, it will do that there. We will ignore missing dumps, and we will ignore dump if DB exists. So database should exist. So not putting those to true, so it will pick them up if it finds any dumps. And then we have the same for snapshots. We don't schedule any snapshots, but we have a snapshot directory if we want, and we can read those snapshots if the database doesn't exist. I have also put every SSL option to false, and experimental features for metrics and so on is also false. These are pretty much defaults here, so I haven't changed much. We also see a couple of commented out here, so 2 gigabytes of memory and 4 threads. Those are also defaults, so you can see that there is a couple of things that you can change if you have a different environment than I do. So let's save that down here. And next up, we're gonna create a service. So this will start running. So in etc systemd system Meilisearch service, we'll create that file and just put a little bit of data into this file. First off, description, Meilisearch service, and it needs the network to be online. It's a multi-user target. And then we will have this runtime directory, Meilisearch. It will create the PID file directory in run. It should be a simple one. We use the user of Meilisearch, the group of Meilisearch. It doesn't have any start timeout. It will always restart after 10 seconds. And this is our PID. So Meilisearch.pid in our run directory. And we will run the executable with configuration file path and then our TOML file. So nothing really of shattering there. We next need to reload the daemon. And then we will start Meilisearch. And we will enable and check the status of Meilisearch. So now we can see that it's actually running and it's up on this port 7700. And if we look at our IP address here, we see that we have 162.168.6.69. So that is what we now will connect to. If we want to do a little bit of an example here, because this is an API, we need something to call it. So I've created this very small HTML file here. So it's pretty much having a little bit of a main body up here with an input string and a result div. And then we will create a client here with the Meilisearch and this kind of host with a port. We also have the Meilisearch script up here, so we can use that. And then I will give it the API key, and we will create an index called Movix. We will run this add document and add a couple of documents here for some movies. And then I will get the elements for the search and result element. And if the search element gets a key up, we will send a search over and it will stringify the result to the result element. So if we look at our screen here, first off, we can look that it's actually up. So if we contact this, we will see that we get Meilisearch is running. And our document looks like something like this. And then we will just see here, search for something and Fury, Mad Max, Carol. And we can also see that we get all the results back if we don't put anything in. Wonder. So we see that it's pretty fast when it searches. And if we want a better example with a little bit more flair, we can look at their where to watch. So this is something that they have put on to where to watch at Meilisearch.com. So it's something that they host. And let's see that we look for Forrest Gump, perhaps. Let's see if it actually has that. Yep. So here we have something. It took a second for it to actually find it. It's a drama from 1994. And more information about that. And we can also see what services we can look at it for. Let's see. Let's search for Wicked. And it found it in 4 milliseconds. So here we have Wicked. So it's pretty fast to find those as well. So this is what I wanted to cover today. This is another part of the LibreChat implementation that we are going through here. So this is the search part where you find documents, probably your other chats, in your history. So this is another component that we need in order to build this system. I hope that you found this interesting. I hope that you liked this video. Give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you have any comments or suggestions, leave those in the comment section down below. And I really hope to see you in the next video.